Namah Shivaya students, today in your physics class I shall show you how to derive the formula for kinetic energy. Last day I have taught what is kinetic energy, the three kinds of kinetic energy, and I have said that the formula for kinetic energy is half into m into v square, right? Half mv square, where m stands for mass and v stands for velocity. So how we have got this formula, that one I shall show you today. Now let us consider, now what I am teaching you, you have to write the whole content in your physics copy. Now let us consider the object of mass m moving with uniform velocity u and displaced by s due to force F. So here we have to consider first that there is one object whose mass is m. It is moving with certain velocity, and due to force F, when we are applying the force F, it is displaced, it is moving to certain distance by s. Now what we know, now you have read in the work part that the formula of work done is equal to force into displacement, right? So W is equal to F into S. Put this as equation 1. W is equal to F into S. S is displacement and F is the force. Name this as equation 1. Now we also know V square is equal to U square plus 2AS, right? V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Now from here we can find out S. So if V square is equal to U square plus 2AS, then we can say S is equal to V square minus U square, because U square will go in this side. So minus U square by 2A. Now put this as equation 2. Now we know F is equal to M into A. This one you have read, that force is equal to mass into acceleration. So F is equal to M into A. Now coming back to equation 1, now we have to put the value of F and S in equation 1. I repeat, we have to put the value of F and S in equation 1, because work done is equal to F into S. So F is equal to M into A. Okay, next W, so putting the value of F and S in the first equation. So W is equal to F into A. So what is the value of F? F is equal to M into A into S. Okay, so W is equal to MA into S, because we have put the value of F as M into A. So W equal to M into A into, now S, what is the value of S? So V square minus U square by 2A, simply put the value of S here. Now see, AA cancels. Okay, so what remains? W is equal to half M V square minus U square. U is a 2 is in the denominator. That means what? We can write 2 as half 1 by 2 M V square minus U square. That means, see, if we remove the bracket, we shall get half mv square minus half mu square. That means final kinetic energy minus the initial kinetic energy. Okay, so W is equal to half mv square minus U square. Now if we consider the object starting from the rest condition, that means U is equal to 0. So if the object starts from the rest, that means U is equal to 0. So W is equal to half mv square. Okay, so putting the value of U as 0 in this equation, we shall get W is equal to half mv square. Now we know work done is equal to change in kinetic energy, right? Okay, because just now we have seen here, change in kinetic energy means what? Final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. So W is equal to half mv square, and we can say work done is equal to change in kinetic energy. So in place of W, we can write K dot E, which stands for kinetic energy. Okay, as work done is equal to change in kinetic energy, so in place of W, we can write kinetic energy, that is equal to half mv square. Okay, so using W is equal to F into S, third equation of motion, and F equal to M into A, and putting all the values of F and S in W, first equation, we can derive the formula for kinetic energy as half mv square. And the unit of kinetic energy is joule. Okay, the unit for both the all the energies is joule. So next class we shall start with the new topic. Okay, so write everything in your copy and go through the derivation. Namah Shivaya.